5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Turn on the torch, light up the flame. Time to melt some glass, my friends. Say, why, here I am to claim to teach and create again. So I came up with a funny song. So I've also done a couple other things. Anyway, I thought I'd do the same thing I did the very first time I got on here, people, which was green exotic in taste and go from there. And I don't know if it's really working well for me or not, but we will find out. For those that are just tuning in, thank you for showing up. And for those that will watch later, thank you for being there. I am slowly but surely coming up on 400 subscribers. I'm excited about that. It's taken me a while. And I'm really enjoying learning about those people who like to learn from me. So welcome to those that are watching and for those that want to watch later, I understand. But yeah, what I'm doing right now, and again, thanks to a subscriber, I am now doing this in more high def. It doesn't look like it at the moment, but I think once it plays back, it should be a higher definition, but the transmission is a little bit pixely at this point. And I will be doing a lot more video demonstrations with the new camera, high def. Thanks to Richard. I appreciate you being there. Hey, Renee. Hey, crazy for you. Glad to see you there. Or crazy for glad, excuse me. Right now, like I said, the very first thing that I did on my videos was I made some green exotic encasement. And so, to celebrate that annual event, I'm going to do it again. I don't know if it's green exotic, it could be blue exotic, but it's one of those two because it's not moon blue. It's a North Star color. And the way I usually tell when I get the rod, the way I usually tell that it's an exotic color, A, it's black, or black to the look or to the eye anyway. But you take and heat up just the tip of it. And when it cools down, you'll see a bloom or an oxide metallic shine going on. And that's one of the exotics. And that's the telltale hint. If you don't know for sure what you got to begin with. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to layer it. I'm heating up the rod, the colored rod that I'm going to be putting it to. Happy New Year, guys. Thanks, Renee, for reminding me. Whole year I've been doing this. And slowly but surely gaining momentum. More people. More challenges. Learning and teaching as I grow. That's the whole fun of it, right? Anyway, I've got the exotic, and I'm layering it on. I want to say it's about a 9 solid rod tube, And when I go down to the end, I usually heat up and pull outward and up. And that usually stops a little bit of the, it will stress crack if you do not keep it warm, believe me. But that's the way I usually do it, is I pull up a little bit. And you'll see that there's little bumpy nubs all the way around it. But that way, that's the best way I've learned to do the encasement fairly easily and any layering on glass at all. Now that I've got it all nice and layered on, I'm going to layer another layer of clear over what I've just done. Yes. They have inspired me. I have to admit. It's taken it in a new direction. But I've always been a teacher when it comes to glass line. And you can see that it has a nice metallic shine going on all the way around it. That it's pretty interesting. Now again, I will layer clear over this. And again, I pull up a little bit right at the last second. For those of you watching in the chat room, welcome. I am doing an anniversary. The first one that I did was encasing green exotic glass, but that's not the only thing I'm going to do in this class today, guy, or this show. I'm also going to be taking requests from just about everybody. And seeing if I can make an image or an idea or a dream that you have in your mind into reality. That's the fun part. My imagination and your imagination coming together and creating something that wasn't there 5 minutes ago. I tell my customers that the only thing that stops me from doing my job is my imagination and your imagination clashing. Now, I've layered it completely with clear over the green exotic, or it might be blue exotic. I get those two confused, but they are close, and they both come out with hues of green and blue. I guess blue exotic comes out with more of the blues than the greens. That's why they call it blue exotic. Now I'm twisting, heating up and twisting that encasement that I just did. And that will cause a nice spiral effect to go on. Hey, Karen, Happy New Year. It's already New Year there, isn't it? And I twist that right down to the bottom edge like that, like so. And it flows right into where the clear is. And all the bumps and stuff that I had, they're both melded in there quite nicely. And now I go back up to the top. And I'm going to go ahead and pull this out into some rods. And then I'll turn around and make it into something. I don't know. Let's see. What's good, green and ugly? Beads are good, green and ugly, right? A mantis. A praying mantis. Looks like a lawn light. Yeah, you would. Here we go. We're getting there. Actually, I'm going to pull this down into a center rod, even than what I got. But the way that I encase it and twist it and pull it out, you can see the color variations and the swirl patterns going on inside that glass. And it's a one of a kind, never to be reproduced exactly like that ever again. That's what I like about it. It's a very nice swirl pattern and gives you uniqueness no matter what you do with it. It's probably green exotic because, again, it has a lot of green overtones, not blue overtones. But I still get those two confused. To get a nice blue like this, with North Star, I've learned to use moon blue. And that gives you the same effect, but a lot more blue colors to the hue than the greens. And again, I don't know why they call it blue exotic when it comes out more green. And here we go. Yeah, I'm going to make this into a mantis. Haven't done one of those in a while. Have you ever made mini mantises crazy for you? I'm crazy for glass. Now, a little while ago, I did that same piece of glass, but what I did this time was before I encased it in the clear glass, I twisted it. And again, it comes out with some very unique and swirl patterns and variations, but a little bit different. That's the cool thing. Never get the same thing twice. Yeah, mantises are fun. They have a, I learned to do them from a man who does glass blowing in West Virginia. Didn't really learn how to do them, but I just, oh, that exploded. That stressed out. Oh, that's right. I heated it up in the middle of the rod. That didn't help a little bit, but that's okay. Now, to do a mantis, I'm going to do the wings first. Let's do the wings in a different color. Let's see, what color could I make? Ooh. Now that's probably blue exotic, because you can see more blues than anything else coming out of that. So we're going to do some wings first. You only did them in clear? Yeah. Well, I've done them in clear, and it's been a while, so, and, you know, it's one of those things, just like if you haven't spelled a word in a long time, some of them you can do right off the bat, but others it's like, how did I spell that again? And using my alphabet of shapes instead of alphabet of letters, you got to realize, especially with the animals that you make, you've got the same basic organization of word or letter shapes, alphabet of shapes, but putting them together in the right order. And sometimes you can start at the head and work your way down to the tail, and sometimes you can start at the tail and work your way up to the head, and that's the way it works. So yeah, it's been a while since I've made a mantis. Let's do it. Here's the wing. It's not going to be very big. You know me. Why make it big when you can make it smaller? Let's see, is this cool enough yet? No! It's getting there. Let's make the head out of this. Get the wings. If anybody has any comments, questions, or no, it wasn't that hot. It was warm. It was a little bit too warm to the touch. It wasn't hot, so I'm okay. Didn't even begin to, you know, not even hearing that that you usually, you know, that burnt hamburger taste when you stick your finger in your mouth and go, oh, not even close. Don't tell me you don't know what that burnt hamburger tastes like. Come on. How many people burn their finger and stick their finger in their mouth? It's a tough job, but somebody's got to do it, right? And the abdomen. We're going to do this off in sections just to make it look good. Now it's warm, cool enough. How's that? See? Oops. A little bit clear. Pull that off. Right thumb, yeah. Ow. Yep. One of the things I tell people about glass blowing is there'll be days of Well, the days that you cut yourself are days of blood sacrifice. And the days that you burn yourself are days of burnt offerings. And I've made a few offerings and sacrifices along the way, to say the least. Yep. And if you, and that's another thing I tell people who are just starting out in glass blowing. You're going to get cut and you're going to get burned. And if you can't get over getting cut and getting burned, then find another something to learn, because you're going to get both. Well, there are those people that can learn to organize and not get burned as many times. And I try to teach safety with my glass blowing. Always put the hot end away from you, because instinctually you try to pick up the end that's closest to you. So if the hot end's pointing away, it's not going to burn you as easily. Unless, of course, you reach over to the other side of your torch and try to grab something. And that's happened a few times. It's been a while. I should have looked over a picture before I started doing this, right? This will work, though. I've shot from the hip and done better, or worse, I guess. Will turn out. Okay. Again, for those that are watching this later, thank you for your subscriptions. And also, I have learned a trick that if you want to be notified about whenever I'm going to be doing a live demo or something like that, that you have to unsubscribe and resubscribe and click the bell, or look at where you subscribed and click the bell for notifications or something like that to my videos as they come up and available. That way you can watch them more live and get more feed that way. Oh, reaching over to the other side. Yeah. I just read your comment about that. Okay. Almost there. Front section of legs, of course, and then your all important cape. It's not a mantis without the head. Oops, I forgot about the names too, but we'll get back to it. Well, no, let's do those now, because it's the temperatures are not stressing at the moment right there in that area. Let's do it. Well, let's do that too. Let's see if we can get all these legs going up about level. There we go. Perfect. Well, close enough. Hold well there. Got that off. For right now, anyway. And the... what do I do with it? You would think... want to do it again? Show me do it. Show me make the room. What am I doing with it? Oh, there it is. Put that stupid marble mold over it. And here's a cool trick. Cold weld situation where you can grab a hole of something at a distance, heat up a punte, touch it too. And this is a very, very quick weld. So we'll see. And that'll help you to grab something on your table and use it like I just did. Thanks. I was hoping so. Are you guys hearing an echo? I actually haven't listened to my sound quality yet but I tried it on another camera and I heard a lot of echoing going on. Is there an echo going on on my feed? I haven't even tried it to find out. Cold welding at the tail. Those of you who are just tuning in, hello and welcome. And happy of the new year. Not really? Okay, good. Thanks. That's a good thing. Okay, now we got the legs, we got the wings, we got the tail. Let's do the praying arms and then the head for this thing. The mantis that makes the mantis the mantis. Come back and add to those in a second. I want to get the other one on too. On second thought, now let's do that. I'm sort of still keeping them up and out of the way at the moment. I will add or re-bend them in a different direction in just a second. So now I'm going to do that just to find out myself. I usually don't listen to my voice. Nope. There isn't really an echo. It's just I am using not the microphone on my headphones, but I am using the new 1080p microphone. I might switch that over to the other one again. Give me a second. We'll check that out too. Just to see if it sounds any better or any worse. Anybody doing anything special for New Year's Eve? I had an invite to go over to a local bar with a friend. We usually go over there to eat the chicken wings and stuff like that. And I'm sort of a stick in the mud, but I might. It's not fun celebrating the New Year's by yourself. The wife and family are in Michigan. Now, the craziest thing about mantises' heads is that they're triangular in shape. You know what? I'm going to do this the hard way. I might even do a trick. Let's try that. Oh yeah, this will work. It's triangular in shape. Let's give it some red eyes. There we go. We got to point his nose a little bit stronger than that. Down, you think I know what I did here. It'll work for now. Point it up. And the mandible jaws there. Okay, I'm getting to the point where if you would like to make a request and see me do something, name it out, and I'll do it. And this is a good time. Still need to adjust that net. Tweezers. Oh, yeah, that's better. That looks like an ant's head. I'm going to take these mandibles off. One thing I like about glass, if you don't like how it's coming out, you can pull it off. Again, anybody have a request? Anyone? Anyone? Bird, an elephant, a cat, a mouse, a swan, a bear, a whale, a snail. I can even do a little tiny something. I noticed a lot of people, you were surprised at how small that elephant was on top of that penny head that I showed off one of my memories. Now, let's... A baby, that's not a bad idea. Oops. All right, graceful. The top part and the back part broke off. Shows you I'm in good shape tonight, right? I'll get there in just a second. I gotta put this guy back together. I know the artist. I think he can fix it. What do you think? That's one thing about doing shows live. Anything can, will, and should have had to happen. It can, will, and do. I tell people if I wasn't in my own way, I'd be in nobody's way at all. But yeah, baby, I could try to do that. I'll bend that in another direction just a little bit more. I was going to do that anyway, but this is going to... And quick cold weld to that claw. Oops. Got the claw and something else, but I got the claw. Here we go. And there we are. Pray for the new year here. Where they get their name from, right? I'll look at a picture of a mantis and I'll do this and another one later on. It's one of those things somewhere down the line I've lost something in the translation. I know it looks nice and people would know that that's a mantis, but it's been a while since I've done one. And we got one nice little guy ready to go. A baby. Huh, you would. Let's try it. A cherubim with it, with the little angel wings and everything. Let's try it. It's doing the face on the thing. That's going to be fun. I'm not very good at faces, but we'll make the baby. We'll even try to put a diaper on it, right? Kick it up a little bit of a notch. And while I'm at it, let's experiment and try out the other microphone again. Testing, testing. Is this thing on? Yeah, it's on now. Let's try that. I'm at a point. Let's see what it sounds like. Yeah, I think that's a better, now that I've listened to it, I think I'm going to stay with that microphone instead, because less echoing going on, and my voice is right next to the microphone, so we'll keep it with that round. Don't forget the top hat and big ears. Yeah, you would. I will. I'll see what I can do. Now you're making me sing that song, Auld Lang Syne, but I'm not going to. Not going to. No, not me. No way. Might hum it, but I won't sing it. Okay. Well, we got ourselves a fat little belly. Fat little belly. And let's get some arms and legs going on here. Medium size, probably about medium rod. I don't think it's five. I'd have to say it's six. Well, before I do that, it's probably going to stress the living daylights out of it, but maybe that's what I should do. Put that in white later on.
big fat pudgy legs, right? You know, I think I'm going to start using the nine wall and pull it down. It's this adding two is ridiculous. Oh, this is 10, but it'll do. I'll put the legs in the right direction in a minute. Little footsies. So what's one of the craziest things you've done this year, Crazy? In glass, of course. Not in real life. You know, well, it is in real life at the same time. Don't get me wrong there. You're right. But you know, like a one-eyed, one-horned, flame, purple people eater or something out of the unusual. You know, I can't even think, but I've done a few crazy things. Most of them are probably recorded on YouTube. Yeah. Hydra, five-headed dragon. Cool. I'm excited for you. I love my dragons. Here's a question for you, Crazy. You've been at it as long, well, probably even a little longer. I don't know. Well, at it for a while. For a while there, are unicorns I could make and sell them and, you know, make an existence just off unicorns, where people, you know, would buy them all the time. And then all of a sudden, couldn't sell a unicorn to save my life. Was it a phase that everybody went through and now unicorns are coming back in again? Putting five toes to this thing. Change the style. Yeah, well, and I could do them with wings, without wings, you know, colored horns, non-colored horns. They just went out of fashion for a little while here in North Carolina anyway. But they are starting to come back, I'll have to admit. I guess it's the nostalgia. Again, it's a phase that I think people went through. There you go. Unicorn lying. Well, I can sell them again. Okay. I'm getting a little too detailed on the feet. Shouldn't have gone that far, but I was in a mood to do it, so I did it. Now let's shape them and get them to where they can stand, right? And then I'm going to do the top half of this baby. Thinking about even putting the sash on here. Why not, right? 2017. Probably looking like an ogre now with the big feet. It's the thing about anything you do, the more detail you put in it, you can make it look good, but you can also make it look a lot uglier if you don't do it right. There we go. Now let's see if we can get this thing to almost stand, and we'll get it standing later. Pads of the feet, heat them up. Press them down together. Now, let's get to the top half of this guy. Yeah, this is going to get a lot bigger than I thought it was going to get. That's what I like about doing these things straight from the hip. Not sure exactly how it's going to come out, but it's going to come out. Adding more glass as I go. Should have been about a third of this size. That's what I've been doing. But that's okay. Yep, probably a good time to put white over the diaper. That's pink, that won't help. Life is a cabaret. Don't know where that came from. Good evening for those that are tuning in. I am doing this live show. Somebody gave me a request of trying to do the New Year's baby. And that's what I'm about. Well, I am in the middle of doing. I'm right now trying to make the diaper to go on the baby. That'll work it for a little bit. Then it's probably going to drop again, but we'll get there. This is just going to be the outline of a diaper. Doesn't help that I'm using boiling glass, but that's okay. It'll do the job. Drawing the glass on the glass. Nothing like putting a lot of stress in a piece of art, right? Yep, too much detail, but you know what? I'm still liking him. Give him a little belly button. What baby is not complete without a belly button, right? Or an umbilical. Gonna put some arms in this baby. If you have a question or want to talk in the chat room, there are several of you in here, and I'm glad to see that that there's a few of you watching. Thank you. I like that. I love an audience. It helps me to produce a little better sometimes. I don't know how it does it, but it does. There's one hand, one arm. We'll get to the hands in a minute. I'm making the New Year's baby. If you were wondering. And for those that are wondering, yes, I have a new webcam, the same practically the same angle. But it is now in 1080p, so you should be able to see a little bit more definition going on in my torch on mine, because I'm watching and also transmitting. The quality isn't as good, but I think once it uploads and watch it straight from the YouTube source, it'll probably be a very nice high digital quality copy. And if all else fails, I'll be able to do a lot more videos straight from the 1080p, and you'll be able to see a lot more detail on my table and a lot more mess for that matter. You know how that works, right? Right. Okay. I haven't seen anybody type anything in the chat room for a while. I'm going to try to turn around and where is that mouse? There it went. There. Just refresh. The colors are vibrant. Cool. Finally, somebody typed in the chat room. Right after I refreshed, I could see that. I wasn't sure if anybody was actually typing anything. We'll get there. Right, right. to do this real ugly head here. The head should be a little bit bigger. Just because I can. Should I put a pacifier in his mouth too? Oops. Stay. At least he didn't fall all over the table and shatter like the mantis did. Yeah, I think I'm going to go down to the local Walmart and go pick me up a bottle of grape juice bubbly. I'm not a drinker. Having a Mormon background sort of puts a little bit of a, I wouldn't say a kibosh on the drinking, but being hypoglycemic, I could get drunk on just sugar water if I wanted to, soda bottle, you know, just regular soda, and have a grand old time just as much as those who are getting sloshed. Oops. Some big ears like Crazy wanted. Should have already gone down and gotten it, but I didn't, but I will. Spend $3. Oh, and Pepsi's are $1 a 2 liter, so I'm going to go get some of those too. I've already gotten a few of those, but they're going to go back up to $1.50 after. Now for hair, I can draw it on like I'm doing now, lightly and gently. Matter of fact, I need to turn down the pressure and do a little bit more detail going on here. So I'm turning off the 10 liter per minute concentrator. Now when I do, you can actually line draw little tufts of hair. Should have probably put the hair on and then put the ears on, right? Right. Here goes the nose. I'm probably going to regret this too. Second thought, no nose, just a pacifier to give it more of a baby look. That's just going to be a flattened disc with a ring around it on his face. There we go. A little bit bigger than it needs to be. Oh, that got a little bit too big. Dang it. For the pacifier. It'll do the job, though. Yeah, I've probably been on this too long already. Well, it'll give it more of a baby look instead of just a dwarfish looking creature. I should probably put the ring on and then put it on there. That's probably, yeah, I'm getting too long into this and it's, how many times can you do a quick ring and now you're trying to do it and it, you could, for some reason, just not coming out, right? Right. And again, the more I put on a face, the uglier it gets. So what I usually do when I'm doing glass blowing, I'll leave the face blank, even eyes. Reason being is what you don't put on, people's imagination, fill in the blanks. And it looks a lot better. Because if you can't make it look like what you wanted it to look like, then it looks worse. I know, I'm my own worst critic. Yeah, it needs blue eyes. You're right. I heard that, whoever said it. Blue or green? Blue eyes or green eyes? Anyone? Anyone? All right. Gonna finally just put on two blue dots. There we go. It looked like orange things right now, but that'll do the deal. Now let's keep going. Need to put on the 10 liter per minute now. Warm this sucker out for a while. And I'm also gonna probably work on the hands a little bit, and then I'm gonna call that quits. I'm wondering if it's going to stand or not. I'll add a sash to it later, but not now. Stressing out over it. Looking good otherwise. Gonna put some palms in the hand, nubby fingers to make it more baby-like. Thanks for being there, Crazy. And I love your input. It's helping. Now he's almost looking like a one of those blimps. I mean, those hands and the fingers that they have. Remember the Thanksgiving Day parades? That was scary, ain't it? Now here's a little trick. I'm going to put a thumb on it, but I don't want to point it in that direction. So I'm going to bend the arm down and then bend it back up so I can put the thumb on the way I want. There we go. Now you could do a lot of this as prep work that I'm doing all at once. And that, that's an ugly thumb. And that you just, instead of, you could do the little hands and you can do the little feet, and then you, all you'd have to do is just, is once it's all said and done, or when you're ready to do the job, you then heat up and seal them all together. That way it's boom, 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 instead of like I'm doing, which is taking more time and stressing out the glass more. And but I'm doing it just because I can. And because I wanted to share the new year. This is almost a deja vu moment for some dumb reason. Never done it before, but it seems very familiar. Maybe I jumped and visited this part of my life in a dream sometime. Who knows? I believe in that sort of thing. I guess you can time travel in your dreams. Is that it? Wish you could learn to copy down the lottery numbers when you're there. But then it's too late because it's already, when you realize it, it's like, oh, darn it. Because now it's at that moment and the lottery's already won. Right. Well, I'm almost at the point where I'm going to call this one quits for now, and I am going to probably go back into it and touch it up here and there, just because I can. This is what I should have done to the other. I might just do that. Take that other hand off and make these fingers on it too. Fun part is putting five fingers on a hand. I tend to only be able to make room for four most of the time. I don't know if that's just seeing too many cartoons or what. I don't know. See, like right there? There we go. There we go. Now heat them up and draw them in a little bit. Round them down. The little nubbies. For baby fingers. looks more like a monkey with a banana in his mouth. A little bit of stressing going on where I added the diaper, but that's why I'm warming it back up and heating it. And I'll seal it all in really well. The longer you're in a piece, the worse you are, worse the chance of it cracking and stressing out. Yeah, I need to stretch them out just slightly in the middle. Just a little bit. Then give them the midsection. Yeah. Yeah, it looks like it got a crack all the way through his midsection, where I added and kept adding and kept heating and kept heating. I will make another one, and I'll make him better. But this one's gonna stand before you guys leave. And if there's any other person that would like to make one more small request, like a animal or something. There we go. All right, Graceful. Of course. Had him standing once, we'll stand him again. All right. Ugliest looking thing I ever saw. The more detail you put on something, wait a minute, let me see if I can get a, I'm gonna have to get a black background. Here we go. Well, that, there we go. This will do for now. No, that won't work either. Can't see the detail and it's not work. Oh, here we go. Pacifier. Yeah, he got uglier as I went on. But I'm going to do one very similar to it and get more time to do it. Have a good one, Crazy. Thanks for being there. Any requests, Bob, before I call it quits for the today's festivities? Plan on doing a few more like this, and I'm also going to try to do the advertising. In other words, I'm going to announce it ahead of time so that people can come plan on being here. And if everybody would like to, on my Facebook page, Melting Memories, give me a day and a time that is more convenient. And if we can all decide on one day and one time, we'll try to do it that way. So, excuse me, one of those days. Just starting to wake up, actually. I sleep during the day and work at night, so that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. Oh, and here's another thing that I did a little earlier for those that weren't around. I did a nice little mantis. It's at the very beginning of this video, so you might want to kick back and watch that at another time or after you finish watching it live tonight. That's a good thing, too. I want to thank you for being there. And if no one has a request, I'll give it about another minute or two. And if nobody comes up with a request, then I'm going to go ahead and call it quits for this edition of Melting Memories, or whatever I want to call it. I want to thank you guys for being there. Also, click like, click subscribe, and also what I understand it. In the subscribe button, there's now a bell that you can click on to get notifications that these things are coming up. So just keep aware of what is and what will happen. And I'm going to try to do these more live and maybe even get some guest appearances like they do on Torch Talk, like crazy. I would like to invite you. I know I've been saying I should, but I haven't yet, but I will. So thank you for being there, guys. And as always, enjoy your day.